The Philippine Constitution is the most restricting constitution in the ASEAN region. That's according to House Speaker Martin Romualdez as he justifies lower house's renewed push for charter change. Romualdez notes this may be the reason why the country struggles to secure foreign capital and investments. He's hopeful charter change will help ease up limits on foreign ownership and solve the issue of investor hesitancy.
We're just thinking of lifting the restrictions as a whole, no? And we will just delegate to the Congress, both the Senate and the House, to regulate our economy, just as other jurisdictions or other countries do, no? Siguro, mas mabuti kasi pag nakikita yung mga investors sa labas na konstitusyon natin ay bawal dito, may limitation dyan, o hindi pwede dito, agad-agad na to turn off.
But not all lawmakers are keen on a potential constitutional reform. Independent opposition lawmaker Ed Zalagman says Filipino patrimony should not be compromised in liberalizing foreign equity and ownership. Lagman adds these moves would be at the expense of Filipinos controlling capital and management. He also points out constitutional provisions are not an imperative inducement for the entry of foreign investments.
The Philippines is projected to be the fourth top recipient of remittances this year. A report by the World Bank said the Philippines is expected to receive a total of $40 billion in remittances in 2023. The country has so far seen $29.7 billion in personal remittances from January to October. That's 3% higher than the same period last year. Based on the World Bank report, India will be the top recipient with $125 billion, followed by Mexico and China. But the World Bank says remittance flows are expected to slow in 2024 to 3.1% from an estimated 3.8% this year. It cites global inflation and low growth prospects, which will further weaken global economic activity. The Philippines, though, will remain a top recipient, with remittance flow seen growing 5% to $42 billion next year.
Vehicle sales in the Philippines up 7.6% in November. Automakers say this is due to higher sales in both passenger and commercial vehicles. Year-to-date, car sales are up nearly 24%, with a total of 390,654 units sold. The Chamber of Automotive Manufacturers of the Philippines Incorporated, or CAMPI, says the automotive industry would breach pre-pandemic sales this year and could exceed its sales forecast of 423,000 units if the sales performance is sustained until the end of the year.
Here are some local corporate headlines. Costco Capital ventures into renewable energy with the purchase of a 60% stake in Katwiran Hydropower Corporation for an undisclosed amount. The Lucio Co-led firm bought the shares from Union Energy Corporation, where Co and his wife are also stockholders and directors. Katwiran Hydropower Corporation operates an 8-megawatt hydropower plant in Nauhan, Oriental Mindoro. Meanwhile, Yuchenko-led EEI signs a Memorandum of Understanding with ZL Machinery Philippines and Chinese construction machinery maker Zoom Lion. The MOU covers the purchase of heavy and construction machineries from ZL Machinery and Zoom Lion for EEI's refleeting requirements. The construction firm says they anticipate a surge in infrastructure projects from 2024 onwards. As for Alternergy Holdings, it receives a capital infusion of 1.45 billion pesos from the subscription of perpetual shares of state-run pension fund GSIS. This will fund the next development phase of Alternergy's projects, such as the Tanay and Alabat wind power projects, under the Energy Department's Green Energy Auction 2 program. And finally, solar power producer Citicor is set to go public. Citicor Energy REIT confirmed reports that its parent firm filed for an initial public offering of nearly 13 billion pesos Monday. The Edgar Saavedra-owned firm is looking to sell more than 3.3 billion shares at 3 pesos and 88 centavos apiece. The offer period is expected to begin in early March 2024.